There's a new Netflix series to get excited about.
Nous allons vous raconter l'histoire d'un voleur, mais pas n'importe lequel. La première chose à savoir sur Arsène Lupin, c'est que personne ne sait qui il est vraiment.
Lupin stars Omar Sy as thief Assane Diol. But he's not just any old thief. His plans are inspired by the tales of the famous French gentleman thief, Arsène Lupin. Now, if you're French, you're probably well aware of Lupin. But if you aren't, well, you're in the right place. Watch on to find out more about the literary icon that inspired your newest Netflix obsession. Arsène Lupin's origins are connected with another literary icon, albeit a British one. In the late 1800s and early 1900s, Brits were obsessed with the adventures of Sherlock Holmes, which was serialised in a British magazine called The Strand. The character was hugely popular, and people would queue at newsstands when new editions were released. When his creator, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle, tried to kill him off in 1893, he was met with uproar. Now, Holmes fever wasn't unique to the UK. Across the English Channel, French people were equally enamoured by the character, and the editor of a new magazine named Je Sais Tout, I Know All, seeing what Sherlock Holmes had done for The Strand, wanted a similar character for his publication. He approached writer Maurice Leblanc, back then writing the odd short story, to see if he could do the job. He came up with a roguish and glamorous character named Arsène Lupin, the gentleman thief. Lupin was suave, an accomplished escape artist and a master of disguise, and occasionally a cunning detective. He was the perfect French answer to Sherlock Holmes. After the publication of the first story in July 1905, Arsène Lupin's serialised adventures in Je Sais Tout became a huge hit. He was a thief readers could root for, because the people he defeated were usually a lot worse than he was. There was even a crossover with Sherlock Holmes in several stories, where Holmes and Lupin actually got to meet. This proved to have some legal difficulties, so in these stories, Holmes's name was changed to, wink wink nudge nudge, Herlock Sholmes. While Lupin may have been created in reaction to Sherlock Holmes's popularity, he became a phenomenon in his own right. As the star of Lupin, Omar Sy, told Variety, Lupin is so French that you cannot grow up in France and not know who he is. Between 1905 and 1939, Leblanc wrote 17 novels, 39 novellas, and several plays featuring Arsène Lupin. Actor André Brulé took on the role of Lupin in one of these plays and helped create the iconic image of Lupin seen in popular culture today. Now, Leblanc wrote some science fiction novels too, but it was his Gentleman Thief who remained his best known work, becoming a French cultural icon. Over the years, the character has been revisited and remixed in many different ways. Other writers have written books featuring the character, including 5 authorised sequels by Boileau Nassajac, published in the 1970s. He's also appeared in stage plays, TV shows, movies, and even video games. And it's not just in France. In Japan, a manga and anime series called Lupin the Third featured a main character who was meant to be Arsène Lupin's grandson. But now there's another take bringing Arsène Lupin back into the cultural conscience in 2021. Lupin the Netflix series weaves Leblanc's original tales into a new and intriguing story. Make sure you catch part 1 of Lupin, now streaming on Netflix.